Hello everyone, my name is Ananya Rajput, a law intern at Lexis & Company from UPES. So today I'll be going to talk about, is poverty a cause of corruption? Now popular belief suggests that corruption and poverty are closely related to a developing country. Corruption has been a constant obstacle for countries trying to bring out the political, economic and social changes desired for their development. Across different country contexts, corruption has been a cause and consequence of poverty. Corruption on the part of governments, the private sector and citizens affects development initiatives at the very root by skewing decision-making, budgeting and implementation processes. When these actors abuse their entrusted power for private gain, corruption denies the participation of citizens and diverts public resources into private hands. The poor find themselves at a losing end of this corruption chain without state support and the services they demand. Now, at the same time, corruption is a byproduct of poverty. Already marginalized, the poor tend to suffer a double level of exclusion in countries where corruption characterizes the rules of the game. In a corrupt environment, wealth is captured, income inequality is increased, and a state's governing capacity is reduced. Particularly when it comes to attend the need of the poor for citizens, these outcomes create a scenario that leaves the poor trapped and development stated, often forcing the poor to rely on bribes and other illegal payments in order to access basic services. For a country, the result produces multiple and destructive forces: increased corruption, reduced sustainable growth, and slower rates of poverty reduction. As the World Bank has aptly warned, corruption is the greatest obstacle to reduce poverty. Now, poverty can be defined as a social phenomenon in which a society is unable to fulfill even its basic necessities of life. Being poor does not only mean falling below a certain income line. Poverty is a multidimensional phenomenon that is characterized by a series of different factors, including access to essential services, that is health, education, sanitation, etc., basic civil rights, empowerment, and human development. There are basically three current definitions of poverty in common usage: absolute poverty, relative poverty, and social exclusion. Now, absolute poverty is defined as the lack of sufficient resources with which to keep body and soul together. Relative poverty defines income or resources in relation to the average. It is connected with the absence of the material needs to participate fully in accepted daily life. Social exclusion is a new term. Now, corruption in simple terms may be described as an act of bribery. It has also been described as the use of public power for private profits in a way that constitutes a breach of law or a deviation from the norm of society. In a wider sense, corruption refers to not only all sorts of improper or selfish exercise and power and influence attached to a public office or to a special position one occupies in public life, but it also includes bribes dealings. Now, corruption and poverty are linked through many indirect channels. On a macro level, corruption has implications for a country's ability to attract investment, for the effectiveness of its institution, for income generation through taxation, and hence in the end for economic growth and poverty elevation. Now, consequently, since corruption negatively affects income growth, higher growth in corruption is associated with lower income growth of the poor. Corruption also affects the way money is allocated within the state budget, diverting expenditure away from less lucrative sectors such as health and education to high kickback areas such as construction. Now, spending on operations and maintenance may also be squeezed out in favor of new projects, leaving existing roads, hospitals, and other public infrastructure to decay. A lack of precise and public expenditure planning can create opportunities for corruption and diversion of funds. at the same time, clearly allocated expenditures may never reach the intended receipts, a major source of deprivation to poor people. While this corruption hurts society in general, it hurts the poor most since they are more vulnerable and dependent on the quality of governance and state support. Corruption also feeds inequality inversely. Empirical analysis suggests that good governance reduces poverty while improving, or at a minimum, not worsening inequality. Thank you.